An important part of isotope dilution, thermal ionization, mass spectrometry is the separation of the elements of interest, uranium and lead, from the rest of the elements that make up the zircon. To do that separation, we use a process called ion chromatography. Ion chromatography utilizes what's called resin, which has an organic molecule which accepts the lead or uranium ion in a certain acid and then rejects it in either a different normality of that acid or in a different acid or even water. That separation takes place in what we call a column. This is an example of an ion exchange column. It's a miniaturized version which has a thin, narrow column, a reservoir at the top, and at the very bottom is a porous plastic frit. We are going to slurry the resin into the column, and that will serve as the matrix through which we'll pass the sample, separate the lead and uranium, letting everything else pass through the column, and then finally strip the uranium and lead off and collect it in a beaker. That pure separate of uranium and lead can then be brought to the mass spectrometer. I'm going to start by washing these columns in clean water. Then I'm going to slurry the resin in from this dropper bottle, place it on the stand for further cleaning before doing the chemistry tomorrow. We begin the process of setting up columns by carefully rinsing out the liquid in which the columns were stored. We do that by squirting water into the column and flicking it out several times. After we've rinsed the column, we're going to fill the stem with water and then slurry a small amount of our ion exchange resin into the reservoir. That resin will settle down into the narrow column portion, and we're going to set it on a stand over here under the hood for further cleaning. The stand serves two purposes. One, to hold those 15 columns while I'm letting the resin settle, and second, to serve as the reservoir for cleaning. We're going to alternate cleaning the columns with 6 molar hydrochloric acid and with water to sequentially strip off any contaminant lead or uranium that might still be on the resin. We're very concerned about cleaning everything very thoroughly so that we can minimize the amount of contaminant or blank in our analysis. I finished cleaning my columns using a combination of water and 6 molar hydrochloric acid. I'm now setting them out under the hood on these lazy Susans. This setup allows me to do many column separations at one time, up to 30 different columns, 30 different samples. I'm going to place the last couple columns onto the lazy Susan. And do the final preparation step before I load my samples. That step is to equilibrate the columns with the acid that we use to allow the lead and uranium to stick to the columns. That acid is 3 molar hydrochloric acid. I've been cleaning beakers on the hot plate overnight in both hydrofluoric and then in hydrochloric acid. I'm now ready to empty those beakers of their acid. And give them a final rinse with clean water. I'm going to use my squeeze bottle of clean water, fill up one of those beakers to the brim, and then I will rinse that out, cap it for use, and continue down the line. That gets discarded, and I have a set of clean beakers. Now that my columns have equilibrated, I'm ready to load my sample from the microcapsule into the column. first step is to take the lid off and ease the capsule out of its puck. I'm going to grasp the column between my thumb and forefinger and invert the capsule over the reservoir. Holding it at an angle, a short tap or set of taps on the surface of the bench releases the acid containing the sample into the reservoir. The acid that I'm loading the samples in allows both lead and uranium to stick to the column. The loading acid will drip through the column and be collected in this beaker. In this case, I'm collecting that acid, which does not contain uranium and lead, because it contains other elements of interest, specifically hafnium, which we can measure by other forms of mass spectrometry for its isotopic composition. The loading acid has passed through the column, and now we're ready to begin eluting other elements off of the column, leaving lead and uranium still sticking to that ion exchange resin. The first step is to elute one drop at a time to make sure that the sample has been thoroughly passed into the resin. After the dropwise rinse, we're going to do a bulk rinse of the column to remove any residual elements other than lead and uranium. Now that we've eluted the matrix from the columns, we're ready to remove the lead. We do that by switching to 6 molar hydrochloric acid. 6 molar hydrochloric acid will effectively strip the lead from the columns and into our beakers. Now that we've stripped the lead from the columns, we need to elute the uranium. We elute uranium off of anion exchange resin using clean water. Now that we've eluted both lead and uranium from the column into the beaker, we need to dry that solution down. In order to keep track of the minute quantity of lead and uranium in the beaker, we track it with a small drop of phosphoric acid. Phosphoric acid has a very high boiling point. Thus, we can evaporate the dilute hydrochloric acid solution from the beaker, leaving behind a very small drop of phosphoric acid, which contains our lead and uranium. I simply remove the beaker from under the column, deliver a small drop of phosphoric acid, and place that beaker on the hot plate to dry down.